Welcome to the Layers tutorial for the Duval Maps My Neighborhood application. In this video, we will be discussing different layers and how to work with them. Let's take a look at the layers we have to work with by clicking on the Layers tab. Layers are organized into categories, and to see the layers within each category, click on the Expand button next to the category name. I've expanded Community, and now we can see the layers in this category. You have the option to turn one layer on at a time by clicking on the checkbox next to each layer, or you may turn on all the layers in a category at once, simply by checking on the box next to the category. Next to each layer, you will see either a symbol or another expand box. If a layer has more than one symbol to represent its data, we can click the expand button next to the layer title to see its symbology. Some layers, like the one found in the property and land-based categories, are too detailed to see from this height, so we will have to zoom in to see these layers become active and viewable. Don't forget you can also view the layers you have turned on and their symbology in the legend located in the upper right-hand corner of the map window. We have also included supplemental layer information for users you can get to by clicking on the Layers Information link at the bottom of the Layers panel. Now that we know where the layers are located and how to work with them, we can start viewing and gathering information, details, and data stored within the layers. Let's turn on a couple of them. Select Council District under Community, as well as Parcels under Property if it is not already selected. Click on a parcel in the map, and notice that the pop-up that appears is not the parcel data but the Council District data. This is because the Council District layer is on top of the parcels. We can use this arrow in the pop-up header to switch between whatever you have selected. Since council districts cover a decent amount of ground, we will have to zoom out to get a better idea of what we are looking at. Click Zoom 2 and the map will zoom out so we can have a better view of the selected district. Note that the council member's name, Reggie Gaffney in this case, is linked to the City of Jacksonville's website to view more data on the selected council district. Let's switch to the parcel pop-up and zoom back to it. I'll turn off Council Districts to get a better view of the parcel. The RE number in the parcel pop-up is linked to the Property Appraiser's website where you can view all the data they have for the selected RE number. The parcel pop-up also gives us the choice to view more parcel details, which will bring up this details panel, which provides us with more data than just the pop-up. And this concludes our Layers tutorial for the My Neighborhood application.